Follow all Moessieurs news on his website, www.moessieurs.com, and on his Facebook Moessieurs and Instagram Moessieurs 13 page 2 for daily exclusive publications.
Hi dear Moessieurs followers, and welcome for that new video dedicated to Samplerobot. And today the topic is about sampling a virtual instrument, because this is something we can do inside Samplerobot. Shoot all along the video, because on the bonus I will show you how to load the library file that you can download to load it on your Montage M or your Mad Express. If you do not want to miss my other video to come, please click on subscribe and click on the bell to be informed when I release a new video. If you like that video content, please click on like. And if you want to support the channel, you have two ways. Bottom right of the video, you have the super thanks. It's like a kind of one-shot donation. You can also become a Moessieurs community member for a monthly fee less than €3. You will have some private video. You will have all the video I release in preview more than 4 weeks before the others' followers. The two are without any advertising up to the public release. And if you book a Moessieurs masterclass with me, you will have 15 minutes extended time.
I've opened Samplerobot, and I'm going to explain to you the basic configurations. But just before we get started, I'd like to remind you that you sample for your own personal needs, respecting copyrights. The idea is, for example, on a virtual instrument in VST2 format, to not bring a computer on stage, by sampling the sound waveform we're interested in, and then load it into the Montage, Montage M or Modex Plus, rework it, and have it on stage with us. Let's start to see the first basic settings to set up if you want to be able to listen what the virtual instrument is doing. You'll see a bit later, we'll be able to load it directly into Samplerobot, which is a host for the virtual instrument in VST2 format. You need to set your sound card output and audio out. It can be also your Montage M or the Modex Plus. For that video, I chose my Luit sound card output. In MIDI in, I set my Montage M port 1. I will explain to you that point later. As audio out, you'll have to set VST plugin here. And in MIDI out, you'll also have to set VST plugin. I've left the Air Drone project open to explain to you a few things. Here you have the virtual MIDI keyboard. You can choose what it controls, either something in MIDI by clicking here. It's playing my virtual instrument that I've prepared, because I've switched to MIDI. If I want to control the wave samples I've sampled afterwards, I have to switch to wave and choose the project. So here, for example, I'm going to play Air Drone now. My Montage M, you can't see it on the screen, can control the recorded waves. You'll see that my mouse is above the virtual keyboard. I do not see a way to play with Montage M the VST instrument. I do not see a kind of MIDI through setting. But then, once I've sampled, I can use my Montage M, my Modex Plus, to listen to the samples that have been made afterwards. For the moment, we're going to use MIDI, because we need to hear our virtual instrument. To sample it, we're going to go here, in the menu to Extra. And there in Extra, we're going to go to VST Host, which is the function that will allow us to open and host the virtual instrument. I'll remind you, it need to be in VST2 format. Your VST2, generally on Windows, you'll find them in Program File, VST Plugin. I can't speak for Mac that I do not use. I've already prepared my work. The first thing to do, after choosing your VST2, is to click on Load. I'm not going to do it here, because I've worked on it for that video, but you won't be able to open it and work with it if you don't first click on Load to load it. I've already done that. You see, Load Plugin successful. I can open the editor, and there you see it. At this time, I'm exploring a lot Arturia Analog Lab Pro, and for this Moessieurs Monday video, I've chosen a bass, a Jupiter bass. You can see that there's not much going on, it's really because I'm in MIDI here. I'm controlling the VSTi instrument through the virtual MIDI keyboard, but if I'm playing from my Montage M. I remind you, here I'm controlling Samplerobot project and not the VSTi, watch out for that. In the idea of my video, preparing the sounds, I prepared that Analog Lab sound, I'm less proficient than I am with my Mod X Plus and my Montage of course. I set the brightness, the filter open, to get the maximum frequencies on this sound. And I set the longest duration, because if you lower the duration, you cut the sound. After sampling and loading, I can rework the attack in my Montage M. If I want to have a good sample, I'll do that. I've cut the effects, I've worked on the master, and now I think I've got a good bass for this bass synth sound to sample it. I can close the VSTi host windows here. Now we're going to start our Project Wizard. As for sampling and hardware instrument, click here on Project Wizard. We have the introduction menu. I click on Next, and there, I select plugin recording VST2 64 bits. I name the project. And set it in the basic project directory. Always choosing 44,100 Hz, 16 bits, to be sure it's perfectly compatible and won't take up too much space. Take a look at my video on hardware sampling, I explain a lot of things, I won't go into it all details again. I could limit my sampling range here, I'm going to stay on 61 notes. I could and it would certainly be much better, if I put at least 3 layers on this bass, but to save time on the video, I'm only going to put one. For key step choosing, 6 is a good start bass. I remind you, it's going to sample C and F sharp, on each octave, to save time on the video. I'm going to set 12, it will sampling only the C on each octave. I'll leave the time length at 2.5 seconds, I'm not going to work on the release. The release, I can generate afterwards on my Montage M or Mod X Plus. Here, just set auto loop on. I'm going to set intermediate. Because I told you, I don't totally master all the settings on Analog Lab, I'll take this option. I'll leave it at 50% for loop point starting to do this video. And now I'm ready. This window opens, and you see that on the side there, you have the little window, where everything is pre-configured. In fact everything's is ready. You don't have to do anything more. Now all you have to do is click on Start Recording, don't worry. You can't hear the notes, unlike with hardware. In this directory it suggests, I save my project, I'm going to save Jup Bass, and now I'm ready. So what not to do, when you're on your virtual keyboard, if I leave MIDI here, I continue to play my virtual instrument, which is always open in Samplerobot. I have to switch to Wave, to play only the samples. There you see nothing and there. Sound good to me. I'm not going to rework the loop points and all of that, fade and exfade. It seems pretty good to me anyway. Especially in the example for this video. I can play them from my Montage M. Look at my mouse. You can see where it is. It's not the mouse that's playing. They're from the Montage M. I can test my sampled notes directly, or from your Mod X Plus 2 if you've got a Mod X Plus. So now what's left to do? Export. Go to export. I remind you my advice. Export to the library file format, to avoid erasing your user data by mistake, if you haven't saved a user file before. The best is loading in library, then import to user if you need to. Here leave it at 44,100 Hz, 16-bit stereo, high quality. That's the good settings. Jupiter Bass. I'm going to save it somewhere easy to find, where I record my Moessieurs videos. Jupiter Bass for the name. To show you that everything's fine, I've opened this library file in John Milos's waveform editor, which works for first generation Montage, MODX and ModX Plus. As we're using Samplerobot on these formats for exporting, we can easily use John Milos license to rework if we need. I can see that I've got all my samples, that the range on the keyboard is well done on 61 notes. If I wanted to extend it, because I've got an 88-note keyboard, here I could extend it if I want. And I've got a performance called Jup Bass here. I retrieve you for the bonus, to explain how to load it into your Montage M or ModX Plus.
Would you like to take in hand, learn or improve your knowledge of your Yamaha synthesizer or stage keyboard? Book your Moessu Masterclass now. Your private session is conducted online through Zoom. Take all benefit of Joel's expertise for all these topics. It's available for users all over the world, through Music Hackspace platform, in English or in French. It's easy. Select your date and time from the Moessu calendar available slots on your time zone. Choose your topic and after your online personal meeting, you can download your session video to review it, as many anytime you need. And now, that's the bonus time.
For this bonus, let's see how to load our library. With our virtual instrument that we sampled, which we'll find here, for me on my Montage M. To load it, I'll click on Utility. I'm in Contents. I'm in Load. I've chose Library File. There you see, in the list, near to Easy Sound Spectral Move, which was in MODX library format, you can see the Jup Bass library here. I've got 7 library slots out of 16 occupied at the moment. I can load it. It loads directly into the first available slot. When it's done, how do I find my performance? You go to Category Search. You go to Bank Favorite Slot. There I have to expand. I'm looking for Jup Bass library name. Here not Narf Sound. But I don't see anything. That's normal. Since there's a category selected, you need to think about removing categories, attributes, when you want to search a Samplerobot performance that do not have it. Jup Bass. Here's my performance. What does it look like? Watch out. You're going to start trying to play. I remind you, Samplerobot is still playing by the MIDI connection. I had connected the Montage M to it, and it still transmits to Samplerobot. So remember to simply to close Samplerobot, to ear only the samples load on your Montage M or ModX Plus. The level is a little low here. I'm going to turn it up a here. Without doing the complete editing, we wouldn't have time for this video. I can raise up a bit here. We're at 127 for performance volume. You see there's no category assigned here, in the subcategory either. So I could assigning a category in bass synth for example. I'll have to start working on the part level. Here we have 100 for the volume. Why not raise it to 127? A little better, and you see that despite everything. Enough good for AC to C sampling. Let's quickly navigate to the element level. Here we have just one element. We only have one waveform. It's called Velocity 127, which is its default name. You can rename it if you have John Milos waveform editor before loading the library. For the amplitude, the level there, you ear it doesn't react to velocity. Let's work on that a little bit. The amp EG, we're not going to touch that too much, the release if I need it. Not too much too. Depending on what you need, there are two ways to work. There are those who will tell you, I want to remade exactly the same sound as on the virtual instrument. I'm more on the other way. I adapt my sounds to the song I'm going to play. I'll make a bass, which will enable me to get closer to the original sound, but I'm not going to go for 100% exact copying. Why? Because when I use it in another song, I'll certainly have to change some settings, so there's no point in going too far either. That's my personal position. I could work on the filter. It's a bass sound. Normally this high notes won't be used too much. We can choose a low pass filter type A, A for analogic purposes in that example. Let's work on the cutoff. Here's where we start cutting. I'm not going to give you all the sound editing in detail, but if you find that the level is still a little low, you can go back to edit part. We don't have set the effects, they can bring add level too, but very quickly to close this video, with the 2-band EQ, you can still go up plus 12 decibels here. Here it is. It's better to listen our sound, and of course afterwards all the editing, you press store to save this performance, and then watch out. Save as a new performance, give it a different name first, because otherwise, you'll get jump bass twice. One here in the user area, I remind you. You don't save in the library space, and one in the library. Just set jump bass 2 name as example. But, be careful. If you do that, don't think, now I've saved it, I'm going to delete my library. The sampled waveform, name velocity 127, is stored in the library. If you delete the library, you'll have no sound. What should we do in this case? In this case, we'll use the library import function before to start editing. Especially when you have a single performance like that one coming from Samplerobot. Load it into the library, and you'll immediately do the library import, and then once you've imported in user area with its waveform, you can delete the library to win slot. Because for a single performance, it's not optimal to keep a complete library. I'll explain this way to work in detail in one of my quick Friday video already release. After importing in user area, you can edit it completely, quietly in user space.
This is video ending. I hope you have liked it. I hope you have find it interesting. As a reminder, you can book your Moessieurs Masterclass directly on the Music Arcspace platform. See you soon for one of our Moessieurs video. Bye.
Would you like to discover, learn, or improve your knowledge of your Yamaha synthesizer or stage keyboard? Book your Moessieurs Masterclass now. Your private session is conducted online through Zoom. Take all benefit of Moessieurs expertise, Yamaha synthesizers, and stage keyboard specialist and consultant for Yamaha Music Europe and France. As member of International Yamaha Tech Talk Live Team, Music Hackspace instructor, and host of the Camelot Pro Sessions, Joel take care of your experience level. Whether you're a beginner or a skilled user, get the most out of your Yamaha synthesizer, stage keyboard, John Mayla's software suite, or Camelot Pro. Book your session for your personal Moessieurs one-to-one session. It's available for users all over the world through Music Hackspace platform. It's easy. Select your date and time from the Moessieurs calendar available slots on your time zone. Thank you for watching this Moessieurs video. Do not forget to click on like, subscribe and click on the bell to be informed when a new video is online. Do not hesitate to write a comment or ask a question. See you soon, bye!